Ah, Steam. Fuck, it's late. Alright, but you gotta get these done, right? Consistency. You can't argue and challenge other people to be consistent and then just fuck off the next day. Though I would love to. I had trouble coming up with stuff to talk about today because I did that thing where you go to bed and you're like, oh, I'm gonna talk about that and that and that. And then you go to fucking sleep, and your subconscious is like, well, here's the answer to this problem, here's the answer to that problem. I throw that out. It's not even a fucking problem. so then of course, my cats were assholes this morning, woke my groggy ass up. Got to have pancakes, so that was pretty sweet. Then went off to work and did work things, and I'm still obviously here. If you can't tell, phone's back together. Yay! And then I literally spent the last 4 or 5 hours trying to think about what the fuck to talk about. Like, do I talk about cryptocurrencies being in a massive red? Do I point out the fact of FOMO pressure and how not following it's paid off in my favor? 10x is currently down to 67 cents, right? So if I would have bought it in $1.09, I would have lost a lot of money. Look, I was smart. Wasn't really smart. I just understand trends probably better than most people. But then I realized, but how do I understand trends better than most people? Like, why can I make that accusation? And then I remembered something that doesn't go, hasn't been around, at least in my book, for years, and that was a virtual stock exchange. And it's, probably the only thing that I ever did well in DECA and in the student store classes and everything else I had was I did really good at the stock exchange stuff. Like, I knew, what to get rid of, how to buy stuff. I think the only reason I got an A in that class was because of my stocks. But it was, to me, I was just like, man, I wonder if everybody, like, do people really, does it get still get taught? Like, is that something that's still around? And I looked it up and it still is around. The application itself still exists. I don't think it's part of DECA anymore, but it's still pretty cool. So yeah, that's kind of something what I want to bring up is like past experience, and understanding of things that can become beneficial to you in the future. And that example is because I did virtual stock exchange, and because of that, and the way that my brain, I guess, is set up for repetitive figures, I'm able to kind of discern certain things. And then there's, luck of the draw, where literally everybody's flipping out about SegWit and running and hiding and selling, and everything's falling to the fucking floor, and I'm just going, my paycheck is not going to survive longer than 5 minutes come Friday. Because I'm just gonna buy, I'm buying, I'm gonna go, I'm already in a buy fucking mood, and I'm gonna be even bigger buy. Which naturally brings me to the next conversation of, the buy versus mine time. Like, when do you mine? When do you buy? When do you play the market? Do you play the investment? Do you go for the long holds? Do you do the fucking day trading shit? Why do day traders hate long investors? I'm in the Superman Facebook group, and I guess another YouTuber, some guy, Brandon BK King or whatever, was like talking mad shit about him and be like, oh, well, he charges on Udemy for his information, and I don't because I give it to you for. Motherfucker, you still get paid. You are on YouTube selling advertisements that most of us have ad block, but you're still getting paid. You're still selling something. This person just was like, oh, look, there's another avenue for me to take this content, take my skills, take my knowledge, and go, look, $10. Here's everything you need to know from start to finish. As I talked about yesterday, I still think it was a good buy. You get into the group and the platforms, you get access to being able to talk to them. You get a chance to affect your community in the ways that you look at stuff, and you get to talk to other traders on a regular basis. Like, he basically has given you a community to buy shares on. Now, there are some jackasses that like to do their pump and dump scams inside of it and whatever, and make your money. I'm an old school hustler. I don't have qualms as long as you ain't fucking hurting anybody. Do your thing. And it just amazed me because the person who was complaining, he's a day trader. He's like, oh, I make, make my gains on the day trading and da da da. And he felt, I think maybe he felt that here's this long-term investor who's like, you know, buy fucking a million shares at point not fucking seven or whatever it is. And this guy's, well, no, man, like, you know, put in your $4, sell it for $6, and that's something. And it just makes me wonder, like, why is there such this constant random divide between everything you do? You know, you always got, or at least in my experience, like, you know, it doesn't matter what group you're part of, what alternative societal thing you're into, or society for itself, for that matter, obviously, there's so many random unnecessary divides. You know, cloud miners don't really trust DIY miners. DIY miners fucking think cloud mining's a, you know, a massive, massive scam. And a lot of the times it is, you know, or they just don't agree with the generated hash rate. And, you know, and then you get people that are kind of stuck in this position that are just coming into cryptocurrencies, and they're like, well, I don't have like fucking $8,000 to throw down on a rig. I don't have $2,000 to throw down on a rig. I have like $500. I can get a, you know, maybe a video card, but I'm not going to get very much out of it. Or, you know, do I buy a Genesis mining contract and, you know, at least see daily mitigated returns of like maybe a year I could pay back, you know, my initial investment, and then I can keep, you know, and as you go, you can keep investing. With do it yourself rigs, you buy the fucking card, and then you just wait till you can buy another card, and you're not really reinvesting into yourself in that aspect, because it's long and convoluted, and fucking make up your own goddamn minds. But it's there, like there's that split, and then there's day traders that, you know, that's what they're in for the adrenaline rush, because that's how they live, and therefore to them, long-term trading doesn't make any sense, because you make more money off of this and stuff. And then the markets that are happening right now, the people that are going to be in a better position really are going to be the long-term holders, because all the ones that are doing day tradings and want to fucking cut and run and do all that other stuff, they're just helping to create a more downturn market. And so the long-term investors are the ones that are going to come out of it on top, really, because you bought it at, you know, fucking 4 cents or 5 cents or whatever, and then the market resets itself. SegWit doesn't, it turns out not to be a fucking horrible thing. It forces a good, you know, push in societal everything else. Stock, everything goes back up. Ethereum and their crap, you know, their random fork finishes. Steam, its fork finishes. I know, like, Sia, they're having financial troubles trying to pay off the devs because they, you know, didn't hold as many coins as everybody else does and stuff like that. So everybody's, like, kind of dumping Sia because they believe in it, but they don't believe in paying developers. Like, yeah, you're the kind of people that, all right, sure, you know, like, there's, I mean, I don't know, obviously there's other options, you know, there's, put a founders, an investment founders thing together where people that, you know, you invest 100,000 SIA, other people can buy it, and that goes to the developers, and, you know, maybe they get their 100,000 fucking coins back later or something like that, or maybe they don't, they just get a product where their 100,000 coins, which are not worth fucking more than, you know, less than a penny right now, or later worth a dollar, and that's what they want. So there's just this, all this crazy, you know, crap going on, and it, you know, just makes me kind of bring up the question, like, how often does this happen? How many times have you Steamians gone into other cultural stuff and just been like, wow, there's these really finite, nuanced divides that doesn't seem to need to be there? Like, personally, I'm going DIY mining and cloud mining because, I mean, I can. I don't really have any overhead as in my life. I have no significant other, and I just have cats, like, besides, you know, so I kind of, but, you know, I'm maximizing where I'm going to make my money by spreading it from mining to hold investing to, once I have enough money, that's the key, enough money to day trade, then I'll move into day trading also. So I think, I don't know, maybe people are just going crazy because they bought in like a month ago when the market was all like, wee! And they're eating shit left and right, and they're not, and they're worried, and they're not in for it for the way most other people do. You know, like, if you, I have friends that are hedge fund managers, and it's just like, oh yeah, shit dropped like 10 points. Nobody gives a fuck. I was like, isn't that like $1 million? Like, meh. Like, you're talking, when you start talking millions, like it's pennies, you get the same feeling. So I think everybody kind of needs to chill out for that. You know, that's it. Like, I really don't have anything else to fucking go off on. I could go off on, you know, book tangent reviews. I can go off on, you know, sexual identity exploit reviews and bad relationship changes and stuff like that. But I don't fucking want to. So we'll just save that for tomorrow when I feel like talking about why monogamous and non-monogamous people and whatever the fuck I feel like. All right. See you tomorrow.